J.C. Robison, number 10 on the court, varsity, her freshman year at Cashion. A talented shooting guard with high hopes of playing college ball.
I wanted to be the best of the best, always, in school, in sports, whatever I was doing.
She'd been playing competitively since the fifth grade, and right as her career was about to take off, J.C. was sidelined by an invisible illness.
Like, maybe something just really wasn't right.
She fainted after the championship game her junior year, the beginning of a medical mystery it would take specialists months to untangle.
I went back to school and I started passing out multiple times a day. And I started just waking up feeling nauseous and just with headaches.
Her health, a slow-moving disaster. Over the course of a few semesters, chronic fatigue, vertigo, and migraines transformed her life from the inside out. The athletic, accomplished varsity freshman graduated high school, limping through practice, depleted by a condition with no cure.
I just looked like a healthy teenage girl. But my body on the inside obviously was fighting this struggle that no one could understand. And it was frustrating for me.
Again and again, doctors were baffled about what was wrong. Several suggested it was all in her head.
They recommended I go see a psychiatrist. Again, like maybe it's anxiety.
Ugh. And the truth is, it is almost entirely in her head, in her brain, the headquarters for the central nervous system. You see, J.C. has a disorder of the autonomic nervous system, which controls automatic body functions like heart rate, respiratory rate, digestion, and more.
This is just the messaging from your nerves to certain organs going awry.
Officially, the diagnosis is postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, POTS, more common in girls 4 to 1, with an onset in the late teen years of adolescence.
It's not commonly understood for people to make the diagnosis.
POTS is a failure of the nervous system to regulate blood flow. Rapid heart rate and low blood pressure cause fainting, nausea, and migraines. There is no fix. JC takes 15 pills a day to manage her symptoms. Immunoglobulin infusions, also helpful antibodies from donor plasma, trick her nervous system into turning off the misfires.
It allows her to get out of bed. It allows her to function like a normal young adult.
Every 4 weeks, JC comes here to Coram CVS Specialty Infusion Services to sit and sleep through an 8-hour long IV drip.
But it's kind of a band-aid. It just kind of soothes them, I think, for the time being and doesn't allow my body to act up.
An experimental cocktail that seems to be working.
I would take it from her in a heartbeat if I could, you know.
Her dad, here for support. Family is a lifeline for JC. She's 24 years old, still trying to figure out how she's going to be able to maintain a full-time job while managing her chronic illness.
She's just got to be very, you know, diligent in managing her time like she always has been.
JC's basketball days are long gone. She is inspiring off the court now. Completing her undergraduate degree at OSU last year, JC decided to stay to get her MBA with a focus on managing disabilities in the workplace.
No, I don't pray for physical healing because I think that I have this for a purpose, and that purpose is to help other people who are dealing with POTS or something else that you can't see, these hidden disabilities.
Inner strength, born out of the hardship of invisible illness. Allie Meyer, Oklahoma's News 4.
Researchers think 1 in 100 teens have POTS. About 80% outgrow their symptoms, though.
As for JC, though, she has a chronic form of the illness, and she's going to have monthly infusions, at least for the foreseeable future.